Good morning, children. Welcome to Chapter 4, Sensitivity Towards Others, Part 1. In this chapter, below mentioned topics are there: special children, physically challenged children, inclusive education, socially deprived children, child rights. In this video, we are going to learn about special children and physically challenged children. Special children. Visually impaired and hearing impaired are special children. You studied in 4th standard about this. Visually impaired means blind. Hearing impaired means deaf. And not able to talk. Those people are called as dumb. So first of all, visually impaired. That means blind. Blind means for them everything dark. See, at night time if power is not there, no light is there, then if you open your eyes also, for you full of dark. Okay, then immediately we will switch on the lights, otherwise we can lit the candle, otherwise we can on the mobile, then some light we will get. But for these blind people, for them 24 hours always for them full of dark only. Children, is it miserable or not? Very miserable, no? That's why for them always they have to stay at home and they can't see anything means only they can hear. That's it. It is very miserable. That's why Louis Braille, he invented Braille language. With the help of that, the blind people also can read. What is Braille already? In 4th standard you studied. What Braille is? Row of riser dots, that letters are will be there just like riser dots. With the help of the touch with their finger, they can read anything in the book. See, here one picture is there. See, she is a blind girl. See, she is keeping their both hands on the Braille book and she is touching the letters with the fingers, and there she can read anything in that book. That means what is there in that book, that all how we are reading the books with the help of our eyes, but she doesn't have eyes. That's why we, with the help of the touch, she can able to read the book. See, she is keeping the fingers, see, and the riser dots. See, the dots are there. Those are also a little bit riser. Then they will touch the dots. Then they can understand which letter is, what is that letter all. Then they can read the book. Okay, children. Next. Deaf. Deaf means the people who can't hear anything. That means for them full of silence only. See, if you keep high volume also, for them silence only. Understood? That means full of silence. It is also very miserable, very sad. So always they have to stay at home means for them also very bored. That's why for them some language is there. This only sign language we can say. See, that means A means they will show the fingers like this, B, C, D, like that all the alphabets are there. Then first, for those children, the teachers will teach with the help of these signs. They will teach the lessons to the students. Deaf and dumb students, they will learn like this. So these teachers, they will get some special training how to teach this language to the deaf children. So see here, they are using some hearing aids. That means partially deaf means they can hear some sounds with the help of these hearing aids. See, they kept in the ear, no? These are called as hearing aids. So some children, some people will be there. If they use these also, they can't hear anything. For them, these all is the help of the sign language. The teachers teach them and they can understand. Then they can write the exams also. For them, exams also will be there. They also will get some jobs. They also will get some education and degrees all. Okay, so then you can think how lucky we are all. Why? Because we are happily, we can see, we can hear, we can talk, we can walk, all the works we can do of our own. That means we are all very lucky, no? That's why we have to be very thankful to God. Why? Because God only has given this life to us. Then always we should be thankful to God. How we should be thankful to God? Always we have to be honest, and always we should be good to others. We should have helping nature. We should not quarrel with others. If you do like these all, then God also likes. Understand, children? See, next. Dumb. Dumb children means the people who can't talk. Those are called as dumb. Okay. Here, in our Vishakhapatnam, Rishikonda Beach, you know, no? Near the Rishikonda Beach, there, one school is there for blind children, and near RK Beach, one school is there for deaf and dumb children. That means there they can read and they can learn there. Okay. So now move to physically challenged children. Physically challenged children means physically they can't do anything. For example, how we are walking like that, those children, they can't walk properly. With the help of some tools or some machines, they can talk. They can't hold things like us. With the help of some aids only, they can do any work. Those are called as physically challenged children. Okay. In earlier times, most physically challenged children were not given any special education and training. The parents were unaware about the help and training that could make their life happy and comfortable. Nowadays, these schools are started and that training also, those children, they are getting, okay, education also they are getting all. But in earlier times, before 50 years, 60 years like that, this all not there. Then those physically challenged children, special children, always they used to be at home only. So then how they can spend their time? Very, very difficult only for them. But nowadays, in recent times, a lot of progress has been made in this field. Now many specially trained teachers and therapists provide guidance to these children. That means not only normal teachers, not they have to get some special training, then only they can teach to those special and physically challenged children. That means if any teacher wants to teach anything to that deaf or dumb children, then first of all he should know the sign language, then only like that Braille language also. First of all, teacher should know, then only they have to get some training for, then only they can teach to those special children and physically challenged children. Their families are also trying to deal with them. Their families, that means mother, father, they also should get some training how to deal with those children, how to train them, that all they also should get some training. And progress in the field of science and technology have made the physically challenged children more mobile and independent. In the science and technology also, so much progress is there. With the help of that science and technology, nowadays physically challenged children are more mobile, means they are moving from here and there with the help of those machines and bicycles like that, and they can be independent with the help of this. See here, these science and technology, I said no technology, this is a chair, wheelchair. See this boy, he can't able to walk, that's why they sat. That means if any child, any person will get any injury or any problem in the spinal cord, then they can't walk properly. See these children, see, with the help of these aids, these only they can walk normally. Like us, they can't. With the help of those, they will walk. These all, see, for this boy here, they kept some rods like that, then he wore the shoe like this. Here also, these are wheelchairs. See, some they have to pull and they have to help them to move here and there. These are all nowadays, these are all available. All the children, physically challenged children, they can use these and they can go from one place to another. Otherwise, it is very difficult for them to move around like us. And physically challenged children require special skills to eat, read, move around, express themselves and use the toilet. See, that means they have to get some training, special skills. For what to eat? If they can't hold the things properly, how they can eat? For that also, they will get some skill. They will get some training. How to eat, how to hold the spoon, and how to read. To read also, they have to hold the book, keep the finger, that for that. And move around, that means how to walk with the help of the wheelchair, otherwise those tools before clipping I show, no, that one, and express themselves. That means sometimes they can't say anything also, and use the toilet also. For that they need some special skills. Who will give that training to them? Family members and the teachers. And these skills make them confident and less dependent on other people. If they can do all these works, how to eat, how to read, to go use the toilet, that all, then they can go to do their works independent, no need to dependent on others. And the teachers dealing with these children also require special training. That means with the teachers, those who wants to teach for these physically challenged children and the special children, they have to get some special training. Then only they can teach and they can give training to those children. And this training helps the teachers to create a suitable environment where special children learn new skills faster. If they get the special training, then the teachers can create a suitable environment. That means if how they teach means those physically challenged children or special children, they can understand fast, like that, learn skills faster. For that they should get some training. And the teachers need patience, kindness and a sympathetic attitude. That means for teaching these special children and physically challenged children, the teachers should have more and more patience, kindness and sympathetic attitude. That means one time or two times if the teacher says they're not able to understand, that's why more and more times they have to give guidance to them, more and more times they have to say then only they can understand. That's why the teacher should have more patience, kindness and sympathetic attitude. And if a special child likes to dance or play, he or she should be provided the opportunity. That special child, whatever they want to do, we have to give for them that opportunity. Then they will be very happy. This will make the child happy and confident. That's why we have to create, the teachers should create that environment to give special skills to those children. See, she is a special child. She is also. They want to do dance. Then we have to create an environment like that to do dance. How they will do, we have to encourage them. Then they will be very happy. Always sitting in the wheelchair or on the bed means it is very difficult for them. That's why we have to give for them freedom also. And here see, that Shriya teacher is giving some training how to do those all. That means they can't hold the things properly. She is teaching how to hold and how to do some activities here they are doing. For that all, she is giving with patience that guidance to them. See, I think all of you understand. A small assignment for you. Special skills can make the physically challenged children dash. Visually impaired is also known as dash. Hearing impaired is also known as dash. Physically challenged children require dash skills. Okay, children? Thank you.